Aggie fans trying to exhort their defense on third down and nine. Corey Warren going for the ball and contact made by Ray Mickens, but no flag. It looked like Warren might have slipped even before the contact was made.
Yeah, it did, and he had a little out route going. Mickens is inside man-to-man. He's got no help in the inside. Under control, Warren slips right there. Mickens makes the drive in the ball. They tangle up feet. That's incidental contact. They can't call anything. Good defensive play by Mickens there.
It brings up a field goal situation. Scott Blanton on to do the kicking. Joey Alfred, the holder, will mark it at the 27. It'll be a 37-yard attempt. And it is good. Blanton knocks it through with 2 minutes and 18 seconds. Remaining in the first quarter, Oklahoma scores first. They lead Texas A&M 3-0. That is the 15th straight field goal kicked by Scott Blanton.
Achilles heel since R.C. Slocum's taken over at A&M. It is the fact.
And it's a little bit different story at home, but when they get on the road, especially in a place like Norman, where it's going to be loud, everybody's going to be against you, things work out a little bit different.
Leland McElroy back to receive along with Tyfel McMullen. And McMullen, hey, a reminder that Monday night, league MVP Steve Young of the 49ers will lead San Francisco into that dog pound in Cleveland. They'll battle Bernie Kosar and the Browns live at 8 Central right here on ABC's NFL Monday Night Football. 49ers and the Browns from the pound. How'd you like that, Ron, when you played at Cleveland, the dog?
I didn't like it, throwing bones at you and everything. Made you want to get loose on another end of the stadium.
That's because you didn't play for Cleveland.
Yeah, I guess so.
A&M first and 10 from the 20. Rodney Thomas nowhere. The Sooners really did a good job of jamming it at the line of scrimmage. Mario Freeman, number 44, and Mike Coates, one of the senior leaders of that defense, number 41, pressuring.
Coach is a man up front. He is the leader, Mr. Experience. He makes the calls, handles all the. He's the quarterback, basically, of the Sooner defense.
Second down and 10. Thomas again behind Gross's block, picks up only a couple. Out to about the 22. Let's check in with New York and John Saunders.
All right, Steve, Tulsa and Houston. Chuck Clements just rockets this shot here. 27 yards to Keith Jack. And look at him jump into the end zone for the touchdown. Houston is trailing 38-24. Meanwhile, Texas Tech has just gone on top of Nebraska 21-20. Back to you.
Man, Texas Tech leading Nebraska by one late in that game. Those Red Raiders are on that A&M schedule in a couple of weeks.
Yeah. You know, Oklahoma did something very, very unusual for them the last few games here. They held on to the football quite a bit.
Personal foul called against Oklahoma. Moves the ball out to about the 37.
That last drive for Oklahoma, they held on to the football for 10 minutes. Total possession. Versus A&M's 2 minutes and 38 seconds. Now that is something that can help you beat this football team today. Keep that running game off the field.
That's true. Also, maybe wear down that fine A&M defense.
Exactly.
First down. Pulick with lots of time. Incomplete. He had a man open, Tony Harrison, but he just missed him. William Shankel, the corner on the right side, number 8, had the coverage.
It almost looked like there was a mix-up in the routes, the receiver. Harrison's going to come down running out, but he doesn't look real sure. He's trying to, and then when he locates the ball, it looks like Pulick didn't know if he's going to come back to it or keep running. Just looks like a broken play to me.
So it's second down and 10, still at the A&M 37. Matthews in motion. Pulling over the middle, incomplete, knocked away at the last second by Brent DeQuasey, the linebacker. Let's get a report on the sideline on an injury from Dean Blevins.
Guy, Steve Solari, number 94, the fine linebacker for Texas A&M, has just gone into the locker room checking his eyesight, blurred vision. They expect him to return. We'll give you the update when they come back out.
Thanks, Dean. He's played very well here in the early going, and, of course, he's one of the leaders on the A&M defense.
That's right. You know, from an OU standpoint, the more of those veterans they can get out of the game and get down in their depth chart, the better off they're going to be.
A&M now with a third and 10, still at their own 37. Good protection for Pulick, who wants to go long, but he overthrows everybody. It was intended for Danny McCray, number two. And Pulick has only completed 3 of 8 for 22 yards so far. A&M will kick it away.
Okay, well, you want to know why things are starting to look a little disoriented for Pulick. I told you last time he got hit was going to pay dividends, but watch this. He gets another hit.
Aubrey Beavers with a shot.
Now, that will put a little different thought in your mind as a quarterback when you go back next time.
James Bennett punts with that wind. And he drives Darius Johnson way back, and Johnson lets it go in and out of the end zone. And it'll be first and 10 at the 20 on the touchback with just 48 seconds remaining in the quarter. Hey, it's just one day until Super Sunday and the premiere of one of those shows you've been waiting for. Yes, get out that cape and tights there. Lois and Clark, The New Adventures of Superman, appears tomorrow night on ABC at 7 Central. Lois and Clark. That's a little different than Lewis and Clark. They were explorers, weren't they?
I'll let you handle that one.
The new Superman series. That was a 63-yard punt by Bennett. That 15, 20-mile-an-hour wind certainly helping. Sooners first and 10 at their own 20. Take to Chandler, the fullback. And James Allen in the flat, but Gundy threw it behind him.
Oklahoma right now just trying to get a quick expansion offense. That's what they call when they get a running back out in the flat real hot before a linebacker can recover and get out there on him. Gundy's got to make better throws there, and they've got to catch some balls, too. They threw a couple out there that were catchable, and they just dropped them.
Clock stops with 44 seconds remaining in the first quarter. And as always, we'll keep you up to date all afternoon long on scores of games that have been completed and are in process. Of course, John Saunders in the studio with updates as well as the halftime report. Second and 10. Allen, big hole, breaking tackle. Mickens finally runs him down. A 34-yard run and a good block by 74 Milton Overton to spring it.
This is OU's bread and butter right here. Counter. They got a lot of mileage out of it last week. Look at the ISO block. Look at the drive block right there on the nose guard. Look at that hole. Allen comes with a good spin move right there and then goes on down the field for a real good game.
Freshman James Allen, 39 yards on 6 carries so far, and first and 10 Oklahoma at the A&M 46. Allen misses the pitch, but falls on it back at the Oklahoma 49.
That's going to drive Gibbs crazy. You can't come with a good play and then do something like that. They've got to be more consistent. They're doing a good job of possession. They're doing a good job of coming up with some big plays. They've got to be more mentally aware out there. The pitch by Gundy here looks like a good pitch. Allen, the freshman, he's just got to keep his eye on it, be aware of where he's at, and concentrate on the football.
Well, as they say, hit him in a bad place, yeah. Right in the hands.
Right in the hands.
Watson Brown next to head coach Gary Gibbs, and that is the end of the first quarter. Oklahoma controlling the football in the first quarter against favored Texas A&M and leading 3-0. As many of you know, there are 5 Texas A&M University players that are not here for this game today, as late yesterday the NCAA handed down sanctions and penalties for those players that had been accused of taking payment and had admitted doing so for work that they did not perform. Well, here's what the university had asked and recommended in their own investigation that these players be given as suspensions. On the right side, you see what the NCAA has given them, including Jesse Cox out for the season, all the way down to James Brooks, just 2 games, and of course, Greg Hill, perhaps.